Jean-Edouard, thanks very much for joining us, and especially given that it's 20 years since you've been at Cofinimmo. EPRA has published a new report, Building a Stronger Europe. How important do you see real estate, and especially the listed real estate sector, within the context of the wider economy?
Yes, it's a very interesting report because it's about building a stronger Europe with good buildings, very good buildings, hopefully remarkable buildings, which is our industry. When you look at listed versus the global real estate sector in Europe, you realize immediately that it's still relatively small. If you compare to North America and to Asia, we have 6% of the sector which is listed in Europe, 12% in North America, and almost 20% in Asia, especially the Australian region. So we have room for progressing in terms of size of the listed sector and in terms of the quality.
So what are the key aspects of the report for you?
Well, first, the report is meant to be material to plead in favor of the sector, especially with politicians and public sector representatives, whether at the level of the European Union or at national levels within the Union. So when we go to them, we have to have solid material, well backed by data and reviewed by external parties. Jobs, tax income for government, the sustainability of what we do from an environmental sense of the word, and also the resilience of the sector, both for the individual investor, private or institutional, and from the angle of the stability of the financial markets.
And how important is this report in terms of bringing this message to EU policymakers in particular?
I think EPRA has really a mission from its investor members, company members, to try to improve the visibility of the sector and to improve the regulation of the sector. As you probably know, some 90% of national law come from the European Union. So it's essentially first at the level of the European Commission and the European Parliament that we have to put our ideas forward. The role of EPRA is to be well aware of what's on the agenda of these institutions, when is the time to go to see whom, and to bring our viewpoint to these decision makers.
And do you think that EPRA and the listed real estate sector in general has been making good progress in terms of this connection with EU policymakers?
Over the years, we've seen EPRA developing a real platform in order to reach out to these people at the EU level, also at the national level. Also good connection with the other real estate association, the national ones in particular. A good example of that is, of course, the regulation for the insurance companies to invest their means into the various sectors of the economy. And Solvency II has been a major subject for us. We hope that in the coming years we will be able to obtain a relaxation of the solvency capital requirements that insurance companies have to apply when they invest in listed real estate versus other categories, including the non-listed. Currently, for listed, it's 39%. Whilst for direct investment, it's only 25%. This will be reviewed in 2020, and EPRA needs to be there well ahead of time with its own arguments, solid data, solid research to make its viewpoint known.
And you've been a big supporter of EPRA for a long period of time. What do you see, in essence, as the main value for EPRA? What have you got from being a member? What's your sense of why you believe that EPRA is an important vehicle for the real estate industry?
Well, EPRA needs to connect, obviously, companies operating in this field with investors. This goes through a number of initiatives, like the conference we have today here in Berlin, but also seminars in various places in Europe and elsewhere. It needs to bring a more easily readable set of performance measures, like in the transparency for not only financial parameters, but also sustainability. So we've done, I think, within EPRA, very good work over the nearly 20 years of its existence on these two counts. On a more personal basis, I would say that the nice thing about EPRA is that you meet peers more than you meet competitors. From the peers, you learn about their way of thinking for the future. You exchange contacts. You gain in ideas, strategic ideas, and this is very, very pleasant for the participating members of the association.
Thanks very much for sharing your thoughts and your work on the Building a Stronger Europe research report, and I look forward to seeing how that actually does influence decision makers at the European Union. Thanks very much, Edwin.
Thank you very much, Richard.